Greetings, Earthlings. I was making a recipe and discovered I'm out of a key ingredient. What is that ingredient? Marinara, the marinara sauce. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tell you my secret recipe. It's not so secret. Every Sicilian in the world knows it. And I'm going to use, because it's not tomato season, I'm going to use whole peeled tomatoes. I have no idea what's in that can. I really don't. It's a big old can. No salt added. We got this at the commissary for like $2. 6 pounds, 6 ounces. So it's probably all water. I don't know what kind of tomatoes. It'll be a surprise when I open it. And it's grown in California. So Angela Mia, so somebody's Angela canned these. Okay, so let me get my junk together and I'll be right back. Poor Mr. Flip. Now I've got to wrap him in some sort of protective coat because you wouldn't believe the junk that's stuck on him. That's why he crashed, I think. Because there was like biscuits and cakes and sauces, pastas, all stuck in his buttons. I'm an abusive camera mom. Okay, so we need a whole lot of garlic, but I just wanted to show you. If you peel it, you cut it in half, it peels easily. You need to take this green thingy out, which is what gives the garlic that icky burn your tongue flavor. And this garlic is Gilroy Christopher Ranch. Okay, so I'm going to get lots more garlic. Okay, so this is 9 cloves of varying sizes with their nasty little middles pulled out. In a cold pan. First, I gotta grab another ingredient. I'm such a stunati. Okay, so for every quart of tomatoes, and I have no clue, I think we guesstimated that it'll be somewhere around 3 quarts of tomatoes, but we're not exactly sure. But anyway, for this recipe, there's only 4 ingredients. And the 4 ingredients are, in a cold pan, put a whole bunch of olive oil. I'm going to put the recipe in the show more box, but trust me, this is not a lot of olive oil for this recipe, the marinara sauce, the marinade. Only 4 ingredients, and they are olive oil, garlic, tomatoes, and basil. And of course, if you want to season it up with salt and pepper, which I'll have to do. Okay, now, so this is all in a cold pan, and I'm going to put it on very low, and I'm going to take my sweet time about it. You don't want it to get any darker than, is there anything in here that color? There isn't. You know, barely any color on it. People say, don't brown it. It's going to get bitter. No, it won't. You can get a little bit of brown on it, but don't let it go to, say, that color, because that's when the bitterness will start coming out. It's okay if some of the areas on the garlic are that color, but not all over, because it just takes it away. So I'm going to just keep this on low for a really long time and stir it once in a while, and I'll be back. So once again, the hardest part of this recipe will be opening the can. Okay, it's been about 15 minutes. That's not what I want, but it's not done. It's still cool enough that I can stick my finger in it, so I turn it up one notch. Let it go. really what you're doing is flavoring the olive oil. We're not going to use the actual garlic. We're just using it to flavor the olive oil. I have a headache. I've been getting terrible headaches for quite some time, a couple months. And it's making me nauseous. So I got this stomach ease. I don't know. Maybe it'll help. Not the headache, but the upset stomach. Oh, no, other things. What I really need is a massage or something. The tea bag says, those who live in the past limit their future. Oh, brother, do I live in the past? I'm still waiting on that garlic. Okay, did you ever see my trash can? It's awesome. Well, sometimes it's awesome. Today, it's not awesome. It's got one of those auto eyes. Oh, I think I turned it off. Let's see. There we go. It pops open if you put your hand on it. And then you can throw all your garbage in there. And then it shuts itself. Pretty cool, huh? Steep 5 to 10 minutes. So I'll do it for 5 because I'm impatient. Now we're cooking. So you just don't want it to get dark. Just barely toasty looking. Some people smash the garlic, but I don't. I just do it the way my mother did it. And my grandmother's. And also, some people dice it or press it, but I don't. I'm a creature of habit. So, let's see. So, I'll take it out as soon as it does get color on it. It smells great. How much olive oil do you use? The recipe calls for about 1/4 cup per quart of tomatoes. How much garlic do you use? Well, gee, you know, look at this garlic. Clove was like a little midget garlic clove, and this one was like a gigantor. So, the recipe calls for 3 or 4 per quart of tomatoes. And that's how much you use. Well, you eyeball it. This is not a recipe you want to can, because there's too much oil in it. But I will be making a recipe that you can, but not today. I have a headache. Yep, looks good. Can you see the coloring on that? Barely. That's how you want it. That's why you use so much garlic. I probably could have used more. So this is going to get tossed. I hate throwing it away because it's sweet and delicious at this stage. The olive oil smells fantabulous. Okay, be right back. I got one of these for Mom and Isa because I use it to make blackberry jam. We have so many blackberries in this area. Anyways, so I got one for Mom and Isa and she hated it. So I had so much trouble. We got to stop all the time and unclog it. I forgot to tell her to go backwards when I got it clogged. Blackberries do clog up your screens, but it's okay. Beats using your berry strainer on your food grinder upper. I reckon that because blackberry seeds are pretty harsh on your equipment. But nothing destroys a fully mill. Anyway, you can see it's getting pretty dry. And then you go backwards and forwards. So, I'm going to finish up these tomatoes. And it should take me another 10 minutes. But you know what? Really, don't can this recipe. It doesn't really, you're not sure of the acid level, so it would have to be canned with lemon juice out of a bottle, and also a lot less oil. So we would flavor it with even more garlic for canning and a lot less oil. Anyway, one time I was telling somebody that, she said, I would never use bottled lemon juice. And told me what an idiot I was and what a fool, because, you know, you can get fresh lemons any time of the year. But, you are not guaranteed the acidity level of a fresh tomato, fresh lemon. But when you buy a bottled lemon juice, it's really, you know, acidified to the correct proportion. You can also use vinegar. I don't think it's as good as lemon juice, but anyway. So to acidify your tomatoes, you have to use bottled lemon juice. And also, you can marinara sauce in a water bath canner, but it takes 40 to 45 minutes per quart. But in a pressure canner, 15 minutes maybe. Okay, I'll be back when I get done squishing the maters. Okay, so Mr. Foley squeezed the life out of these tomatoes. There's nothing in there really, but tough pulp that wouldn't go through the strainer, the cores, and all the seeds. I never ever want to put seeds in this sauce because, I don't know, I don't like seeds. I like a refined sauce. I don't want skin. I don't think it's polite to serve your guests cooked tomato skins, cooked eggplant skins, yada yada yada, because they're like eating cellophane. Okay, me and my headache are going to sit down. I'm going to put that on medium and cook it 15 minutes, stir it up, check it again. So it will probably go about 40 minutes, 30 maybe. Okay, so me and my headache are going to go lay on the couch for a few minutes. Okay, so these tomatoes, they're sweet. They are not bitter in any way. They're very watery, so it's going to go probably 35 minutes. But I'm going to evaporate it down as best I can. Oh, that's too noisy. Okay, I have it pretty much where I want it. Well, close to it anyway. I don't want it too thick, because I'd have to water it down for my recipe. But now you add ingredient number 4. I don't have fresh basil, so I'll use this for this recipe. It's going to be cooked forever, so it'll be just right. That's it. Now you want to taste it, and check it for how much salt you want to put in it. Oh yeah. Need salt. I'm going to lower it to a simmer. The total cooking time on this is under 40 minutes. I'm going to put about, where are you? That much salt. And I'm not putting pepper in because the recipe's got a big old hairy bunch of pepper. Dang, that's good enough to eat. Yep, has to cook a little bit more for that salt to go in, but see, I reduced it by, where was it, up here? So, a fourth. Gee, that's good, and it smells good. Okay, that's the marinade, and I hope you try this, because it's a true marinara sauce. You don't have to put anything more in it. just your olive oil, your garlic, your tomatoes, and some basil. And then season it to taste with salt and pepper. So basically, four ingredients. Now, people think marinara sauce means it's got seafood in it. No, it doesn't. It's just a fast, easy sauce that you can make. Maybe when you're standing on the shores of the ocean, waiting for your husband to come home with a big old fish. Or maybe it's because it means of the sea, meaning sailors can carry it to the sea. And the ingredients are so, I guess, they can be traveled. They can put them in a jar and bring them out on a boat and cook with them. But it really does not mean you put any kind of seafood in it. You can, but the marinara sauce is just the four ingredients and whatever salt and pepper you like. Okay, that's the end of that. And I'll make another video after I charge Mr. Flip.